This goes back to when we're going to raise our sticks. We're not going to raise our sticks. Was everybody on board with the plan?
I think
there's just so much miscommunication or lack of communication or disruption, disorganization, whatever you want to call it.
They've already called it. There is no leadership. And that's pretty apparent. And that's their problem. It's an intangible feature of every team. Usually you inherit it and the leader makes himself a leader. Well, we don't have one human being in that group of 23 that could ever be a leader.
But Billy, you're right. There is no leadership. They look lost. And it's the other day when we were on the show and we were talking about the Raptors on how confident the team is and comfortable they are with each other. You guys right away gave credit to their leader, right? That there was great leadership and they're singing the same tune and they're in harmony. And that's a problem that the Leafs have had for the last 4 or 5 years. And I think Pat Quinn was a good leader. And I think that Pat Quinn rallied the team rallied around Pat Quinn. The team rallied around Pat Burns. And I think that that's the difference with Randy Carlyle. I don't think that team ever rallied around their coach. And I think that the team is not rallying around their captain. You need a captain. Wendell Clark was a great captain. Matt Sundin was a great captain. These guys were great leaders, and the team really respected them.
But you can put a C on a player's jersey. That doesn't necessarily make him a leader.
Well, Phaneuf, to me, I think that the big turning point of the relationship for me with Phaneuf as a captain, not as a player, was when one of his players got whacked big time behind the net, and he just looked over and still walked off the ice. Now, if you're the captain and it's your teammate and he's on the ground and nobody knows if he's having a concussion or he's been hurt bad, you're gonna skate over to see what's going on. Mm-hmm. You don't take a little look behind you like you're changing lanes and then walk off. I think that was a big...
Well, I'll give you a more current example. We got one of the Stahl brothers winding up and taking a shot at Dion Phaneuf because they don't have a goalie in there, is basically saying, I'm going to shoot at you. I don't care who you are. And nobody from the Leafs batted an eye. It was 100%. Not a big deal. And I'll tell you something else. Phaneuf at least fought.
But he'll fight.
He fought twice. But he's the only guy that, you know, say what you will about him, but he fought. You know, he stood up there. Again, there's
somebody... Who says, Perry?
What's that?
Who fought? Phaneuf?
When Phaneuf fought twice.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Now he's out now because of the apparent hand injury he got from the fight. You can look at him in a variety of different ways, but just look at the recent examples of a guy who stood up and yet a guy who basically put himself in front of a guy who's about to blast a puck at him at 100 miles an hour.
I think what you're saying has a very huge meaning that Stahl didn't give a shit. Like a lot of
not only did Stahl not give a crap, because Dion Phaneuf fought his brother. He said, you want to fight my brother? I'm going to take a slap shot right at you. Go ahead, man, because he stood up for his brother. That was leadership right there. What happened was...
He stood up for his brother when Phaneuf cheap-shotted him. The thing you have to remember about Phaneuf is not how many times he's fought, is how many times he's turned down fights.
You know, Billy, I know you're a big fan of Phaneuf, and I'm indifferent, if I may use that. But I haven't seen him... Like, I see that he takes a lot of shit, but the other thing that that bothers me, and I think that's what Perry's touching on, is that I don't ever see him get backed up by the rest of the team. I really don't see any, like usually when the other night, which game was I watching, the opposing player got hit and the whole team just went at him, at the player. I forget which game I was watching, but it reminded me.
When the defenseman got hurt, Letang. Somebody hit Letang from behind.
And it reminds me of a game between the Philadelphia Flyers and the Toronto Maple Leafs. And Eddie Shack was playing for the Toronto Maple Leafs. And he pissed off the Flyers. And they were all chasing him. Mm-hmm. The whole fucking team. And there was not one Leaf. Do you remember that one?
Yeah.
There was not one Leaf that was coming to Eddie Shack's defense. Not one Leaf. So what does that tell you about the relationship he had with his team?
Well, one thing to talk about Eddie Shack. Now we're talking about Dion Phaneuf. Eddie Shack was the entertainer. So when he's basically skating backwards, you know, because they're all coming after him. Let's talk about now.
No, but I'm just telling you, it's the same thing. Fanof, I have seen four or five examples, maybe more, where there's two guys or one guy and they're really at him, and there's not nobody coming to defend him. Not even one guy. Usually, you know, they rally your team. I was always taught to play for my team. I was a goalie, but if my defenseman was getting roughed up, I would fucking get in there. I mean, it is what it is, and I can still throw them. And you got to defend your team. End the story. You got to defend your team, right, Bill?
Absolutely. But I mean, the problem is, as apparent as you've just said, Frank, you can't find any evidence of any player on the Toronto Maple Leafs who gives a goddamn about Dion Phaneuf.
Yeah, I think that there's naive, but I think there's a disconnect between him and the team.
There's a disconnect between every part of this organization. There is absolutely no connection.